Magandang gabi, magandang araw po. Welcome back for those who are in day 2. And for those who are in day 1, ito ko yung unang gabi nyo ho at araw po ng pagsali po sa Soulergy. Ito po ay ating pong ginagawa for 20 days, Monday hanggang Friday po, for 30 minutes po. Sana makasama ho namin kayo, hindi lang po ngayong gabi at sa mga susunod po na mga araw po. For 1 month or 20 days to be exact, from Monday till Friday. We're in day 2 and we'll continue with Psalm 86. Basahin lang ho natin yung verses 7 to 10 and verse 15 to 16. This a prayer po of David. Sabi ho niya sa verse 7, when I am in distress, hindi ho dessert, hindi ho shopping. When I am in distress, I call to you because what? Because you answer me. Importante po yun sa ating pagtawag, that we believe and trust that God will hear us and answer us. Verse 8, sabi ho ni David, among the gods, there is none like you, Lord. No deeds can compare with yours. All the nations you have made will come and worship you before you, Lord. They will bring glory to your name, for you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God. Verse 15, but you, Lord, are a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness. Verse 16, sabi ho ni David sa kanyang panalangin, turn to me and have mercy on me. Show your strength in behalf of your servant. Save me because I serve you. Kung kagabi ho o kahapon po nagsimula tayo for acknowledging that we are weak and we are in need of God, that we are needy people, that we're desperate po, and the reason we turn to God in prayers because, Lord, ito po, may mga bubunin kami sa panalangin po. Tayo po sa ating Soulergy, hindi po to personal prayer concerns. Ito po ay pagbuno po sa mga darating pong mga events, lalo na hong Easter po sa April 17. Muli sa mga yun lang po nakadaluho, ang ating summit ng April 27 to 30, ito ho yung kapalit po ng ating 3 days prayer and fasting on-site na nagsimulan po nakaraan pong taon. But syempre, yung ating pong anniversary as a church Pinnacle Village sa Mayo ho. Dito makita ho natin po sa ating binasa, simula po verses 7 to 10, 15 and 16. Makita ho natin, David began to turn his focus on God's attributes. Hindi lang ito yung, Lord, I am poor, I am needy. But he was able to focus and see, acknowledge God's attributes, that he was great, and then he offered praise. 7 times in the entire chapter of 86, David used the name Adonai or Lord. Ano yun? Nasa verse 3, verse 4, verse 5, verse 8, verse 9, verse 12, verse 15. Anong ibig sabihin po when you use the word Adonai or Lord? It means you're emphasizing God's lordship and sovereignty. I guess when we approach God's holy throne, what do we do? Kaya nga ho, laging tinuturo po sa atin po sa panalangin po sa ating church, hindi kagad hihingi sa ating paglapit sa Diyos. But we need to be able to approach God's holy throne by knowing and believing that He hears and answers our prayers. We must acknowledge and make God the God who is merciful and gracious. Sa verse 15, slow to anger, and He was abundant or is abundant in loving kindness and truth. This is the reason we begin to enter into prayer. We begin by praising Him for who God is. Doon tayo nagsisimula lagi eh. Kasi ito ho, importante po that we acknowledge the attributes of God. Nagkakaroon tayo ng confidence po sa panalangin. Hindi lang ho dito. Okay? Sa ating pong binabasa po, kahit po mamaya ho, sa aking babasahin po sa Mateo 6. But again, Psalm 86. It shows that David knew the God to whom he was praying. He was a man of faith, a man of confidence in God's ability to answer his prayers. Verses 6 and 7. Anong sabi niya? Hear my prayer, Lord. Listen to my cry for mercy. Verse 7, when I am in distress, I call to you because you answer me. Alam mo, para sambitin po at sabihin po ni David because you answer me, I guess something that he experiences every single time. Hindi ito pa minsan-minsan or random po. Kaya ako, grabe yung kanya pong confidence and boldness to come before God in faith that when He comes, God hears and listens. Yun ho tayo. May ganong klaseng pananampalataya po na ang Diyos po makapangyarihan. That's why we call Him Lord. Kahit po sa bagong tipan in the Lord's Prayer. Jesus taught us the pattern of prayer in Matthew 6. Ito pong sabi po sa verses 9 and 10. This then is how we should pray. San ho siya nagsimula? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. There's a reason po when we begin in prayer po, what do? Okay? Yung facilitator po o yung pastor po ang sinasabi, let's begin to worship and praise God. Doon tayo nagsisimula. Nasa laki ng ating problema, ang una mo muna nakikita po ay ang laki ng Diyos makapangyarihan. And today, day two, it is important for us to be reminded that as we enter God's presence in prayer, that we need to focus on who God is. That He is great, or His greatness, His goodness, His faithfulness. Again, David acknowledged who God is in verses 10 to 15. Sabi ho niya, paalala uli, Lord, you are great. Ganda, no? And you do marvelous deeds. You alone are God. But you, Lord, are a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness. No one reason we have the confidence to come in prayer, ni tayo takot ho. May ganong tapang humingi, parang anak po sa kanyang tunay na magulang. Alam nyo, yung anytime pwede siyang lumapit. Di ba? May ganong klaseng boldness at confidence. And we too, when we come before God in prayer, we have this confidence to come in prayer not because we are good, but because God is good. 1 John chapter 5, verses 14 to 15, paalala ho the voice version. We live in the bold confidence. Underline those words. We live in the bold confidence that God hears our voices when we ask for things that fit His plan according to His will. Verse 15, and if we have no doubt that He hears our voices, we can be assured that He moves in response to our call. I remember a man named George Mueller. Isa ho yan sa ating pong idolo sa pananampalataya ho. Si George Mueller emphasized the importance of believing God's ability and willingness to answer our prayers. Ito po ang sabi niya, I have found invariably in the 54 years and 9 months which I've been a Christian that if only I believe, I was sure to get in God's time the things that I asked for. Grabe yung kanyang assurance, no? Grabe yung experience niya ho kung paano sumasagot ang Panginoong Diyos. 54 years and 9 months to be exact. Kumusta kaya ho tayo? Ang ating experience ho ng kapangyarihan ng Panginoong Diyos that when we pray, when we begin to pray and we believe, experience that God hears and answers our prayers, will always come because we have an experience of the power of God to answer our prayers. Ituloy kong sabi ho ni George Mueller, I would specially lay this on your heart that you exercise faith in the power and willingness of God to answer your requests. We must believe that God is able and willing. Importante po yun. To see that He is able, we have only to look at the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. For having raised Him from the dead, He must have almighty power. As to the love of God, you only have to look to the cross of Christ to see that His love is not sparing His Son and not withholding His only begotten Son from death, but guarantees us His love with these proofs of the power and love of God. Assuredly, if we believe, we shall receive. Simpleng statement lang ho, ano? But si George Mueller was an example, a model of a simple man, but with faith in the God who is good, the God who is gracious, the God who hears and answers our prayer. And maybe tonight or today, let all also begin again focusing on who God is. Doon ho tayo magsimula uli. Karugtong ho nung kagabi ho. Because in life, may dalawang options lagi tayo in any situation. You can either worry and see that your problems are big or bigger than God, or you can worship and you begin to focus on who God is. That God is bigger than the problems that we face. Anyway, you'll do one or the other. You can either panic, and some of us are panicking because of what's happening now, or we can pray. We can tremble or fear, or we can trust God. You can have fear, or you can have faith. It's our choice. Sana sa ating pagpapatuloy ho ng ating pagbunong sa panalangin, pagkatapos nito, is we come and worship God, acknowledge not only our need of Him because we're poor and needy. I hope that tonight we begin to see not only His promises, but God's attributes, that He is good, that He does wondrous things, that He does the impossible, that He hears and answers our prayers.